Operation. Taking on vacant homes and neighborhood blight in the city of Warren, 21 News reporter Anita Quinn joins us from our Eastwood Mall Bureau with what local community groups are recommending.
The Mahoning Valley Organizing Collaborative just released their 2010 survey on vacant properties for the city of Warren. The numbers are not great, with over 6,000 vacant lots alone, but the group does have some suggestions to turn that around.
The survey by the Mahoning Valley Collaborative Organization covered over 24,000 parcels in the city of Warren. Of that number, 15,000 are occupied. The study broke down vacant lots, vacant and non-vacant structures. When it came to vacant lots, it totaled over 6,000. The majority of that was on the southwest side of the city, which had 2,868. Out of all the vacant lots, 4,000 were privately owned. MVOC made four recommendations to the city. Utilize the county's land bank initiative, giving neighbors a chance to buy vacant lots near their homes at a minimal price.
To give you an idea of what we're saying there, a side lot, a 25-foot side lot in the city of Warren, the adjacent property owner can end up owning it for about $205.
The group also recommended that 25% of the city's demolition fund be used to take down structures that the group gave an F grade. Updating the city's computer software to track rental property owners with the help from citizens. MVOC says it could bring more revenue to the city of Warren.
You simply report it, and then you can and what we would like is that you can track the progress and see, has this property actually been checked, and has it been checked this year?
The last recommendation is a nonprofit resolution that would allow community groups that are currently cleaning up their neighborhoods to turn in receipts to be added to the taxes of negligent property owners. MVOC believes it would expedite vacant structures into the county land bank. With more local news, I'm Anita Quinn.